Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the precision rectifier and we will also see how to design it. Now the first question which comes in our mind is, what is precision rectifier and how is it different from the normal rectifier circuit? So first of all, let us understand that. Now in the previous videos, we have learned about the half-wave rectifier circuit. And if we assume this diode as an ideal diode, in that case, whenever the sine wave is applied to this rectifier circuit, then at the output, we will get either positive or negative half cycle. So here as you can see, we will get only positive half cycles. And for the ideal half wave rectifier, the transfer characteristic will look like this. It means whenever the input is negative, at that time, the output will be zero. And whenever input is positive, at that time, the output will follow the input signal. But in actual rectifier circuit, this diode will conduct only when the applied input signal is more than the forward voltage drop across the diode. And if you see the actual waveform of the rectifier, then it will look like this. So the peak waveform of the rectifier will be slightly less than the ideal rectifier output. And if you see the transfer characteristic, then it will look like this. So as you can see over here, the diode will start conducting only when this applied input signal is more than this threshold voltage. Now this voltage drop across the diode will not be a much problem for the AC to DC conversion, because in this case, the applied input signal across the rectifier used to be a much larger than the threshold voltage drop across the diode. But whenever this rectifier circuit is used for the small signal conditioning and signal processing, then it will not work. For example, let us say the input that is applied to this rectifier is smaller than this diode voltage drop. So in this case, this rectifier circuit will not be able to rectify the signal. For example, let us say you want to demodulate the AM signal. Now usually the received signal strength used to be a much smaller than the diode voltage drop. So in this case, suppose if you want to demodulate this envelope from the carrier signal, then it is not possible in case of the normal rectifier circuit. So in such case, the precision rectifier circuit is very useful. So this circuit is designed using the op-amp and diode. And in this rectifier circuit, the diode acts like an ideal diode. So the rectifier circuit will behave like an ideal rectifier circuit. And because of this, this circuit is also known as the super diode. So if you see the transfer characteristic of this precision rectifier, then it will look like this. So now let us understand how the circuit works. So whenever the applied input signal is positive, that means Vin is greater than zero. In this case, the diode will behave like a closed switch. So if you see the circuit, it is nothing but the buffer circuit. So whatever input is applied to this positive terminal of the op-amp, the same input will appear across the output terminal. That means whenever the input is greater than zero, at that time, the output will follow the input signal. And whenever the input is less than zero, at that time, the diode will get reversed biased and simply it will act as an open switch. So in this case, the output of this rectifier will be equal to 0 volt. Now in this circuit, this diode behaves like an ideal diode, because if you observe the circuit, here this diode is connected in the feedback loop. Now here, let us assume that Vf is the voltage drop across this diode. And whenever this diode is connected in the closed loop configuration, then the effective voltage drop will get divided by the open loop gain of this op-amp. So for example, let us say the drop across this diode is equal to 0.7 volt. And usually the open loop gain of the op-amp used to be in the range of 10 to the power 5 to 10 to the power 6. So here let us assume that that is equal to 10 to the power 5. So now if you see the effective forward voltage drop, it will be approximately equal to 0. So we can say that in this closed loop configuration, the effective forward voltage drop across the diode is equal to 0 volt. And that is why it behaves like an ideal diode. So now let us analyze this circuit for the different cases of input signal. Now first of all, let us assume that for the given input signal, this diode is conducting. And also assume that the output of this op-amp is equal to VO dash. So as this diode is conducting, there will be a drop of 0.7 across this diode. And here we are assuming that the silicon diode is used in this rectifier circuit. So the Vout will be equal to this VO dash minus 0.7 volt. Or in another way, we can say that this VO dash will be equal to Vout plus 0.7 volt. So this will be the output of this op-amp. Now if you observe the circuit, here as this diode is conducting, so this path will get completed. Or we can say that the op-amp is operated in the negative feedback configuration. And we know that in this negative feedback configuration, we can apply the concept of either virtual ground or virtual short. So let us quickly prove that even if this diode is connected in the feedback path, then also it is possible to apply the concept of virtual ground or virtual short. Now for op-amp, we know that the output voltage VO can be given as the open loop gain multiplied by the difference between the two input signals. So let us say the input that is applied at the positive terminal is equal to V plus, and the input which is applied at the negative input terminal is equal to V minus. So the output will be equal to the open loop gain times the difference between the two input signals. Now this VO dash can be written as VO plus 0.7 volt, and that will get divided by the open loop gain. Now as we have just seen, the open loop gain of the op-amp used to be a very large. So this quantity will be approximately equal to 0. And that will be equal to the difference between the two input signals. So we can say that whatever input that is applied at the positive terminal, the same input will appear at the negative terminal. And if you observe over here, this V minus is connected to the output. So at the output also, we will get the input voltage. That means V out will be equal to V in. So whenever this diode is conducting, at that time the output voltage will follow the input voltage, and this diode will conduct only when the applied input voltage is greater than 0. Now similarly, let us analyze the circuit for the negative input voltage. Now for a moment here, let us assume that this diode is non-conducting. So if this diode is non-conducting, in that case the op-amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And if you observe at this node, then the output at this node will be equal to 0, because this Vout is connected to the ground through this load resistance. And as this output terminal is also connected to the negative input terminal of the op-amp, so at this terminal also the output will be equal to 0 volt. Now if you observe over here, the diode is reverse biased, and one end of the diode is connected to the 0 volt. It means that at this terminal the voltage should be negative, and that is only possible whenever the applied input voltage to the diode is negative. So now let us see the output waveform of this precision rectifier. So let us say this sine wave is applied as an input to this rectifier circuit, and if you see the output, then it will look like this. So whenever the input is greater than 0, at that time the output will follow the input signal, and whenever input is less than 0, at that time the output will be equal to 0. Now in this precision rectifier circuit, there is a one limitation. So let us see that. So let us assume that the input that is applied to this rectifier is less than 0, and we have seen that in that case the output of the op-amp will be equal to the negative saturation voltage, and in this condition the op-amp will also operate in the open loop condition. Now whenever this input becomes positive, at that time the first of all op-amp needs to come out of this negative saturation voltage. So it will take some time for the op-amp to come out from this negative saturation voltage to some finite positive voltage. Now this will not be a problem for the op-amp whenever it is operated at low frequencies. Let us say it is operated at 50 to 100 Hz. But whenever it is operated at much higher frequencies, let's say in 50 to 100 kHz, at that time the output of the op-amp will get distorted, because the op-amp will take some time to come out from this negative saturation voltage to some finite voltage, and this will limit the maximum operating frequency for the rectifier circuit. So suppose if you want to increase the operating frequency range, then somehow we need to prevent this op-amp from going into the negative saturation. and that can be avoided by using this modified circuit. So using this circuit, we can prevent the op-amp from going into the negative saturation. So let us understand how this circuit works. So in this circuit, whenever input is greater than 0, at that time the output of the op-amp will be equal to 0, because in this case this diode D1 will conduct and this diode D2 will be off, and the output will be equal to 0 volt. And whenever this input is less than 0, at that time this diode D1 will be off and this diode D2 will conduct, and the output of the rectifier circuit can be given as minus R2 by R1 times input voltage. So if you see the output of the circuit, it is never going into the saturation. So in this way, we can prevent the circuit from going into the negative saturation. So now let us analyze this circuit and let us understand how this circuit works. Now in this circuit, for a moment, let us assume that this diode D1 is conducting. And whenever this diode D1 will conduct, at that time, this path will get completed. And because of the completion of this path, we can say that there is a negative feedback from output to the input side. It means that the op-amp is operated in the linear region, and we can apply the concept of virtual ground. And we can say that this node over here will be at a ground potential, because this positive input terminal is also at a ground potential. So as this diode D1 is conducting, so there will be a 0.7 volt of voltage drop across this diode. So at this node, the voltage will be equal to 0 minus 0.7, that is equal to -0.7 volt. Now if you observe this output terminal, it is connected to the ground through this resistor RL, and it is also connected to the ground terminal through this resistor R2. It means that the output of the circuit will be equal to 0 volt. So no current is flowing through these two resistors. It means that the cathode of the diode D2 will be at a 0 voltage, and you can say that this diode D2 is non-conducting. Now as this diode D1 is conducting, so some forward current will also flow through this diode, and it should flow in this direction. So if you apply the KCL at this node, then some finite amount of current should also come into this node, and that is only possible whenever the applied input signal is greater than 0. So we can conclude that whenever the input signal is greater than 0, at that time D1 will conduct and D2 will remain off, and the output of the op-amp will be equal to 0 volt. Similarly, now let us analyze the circuit for the negative input voltage. So now here, let us assume that the applied input signal is less than 0 volt. Now here, for a moment, let us assume that this diode D1 is conducting. And if it is conducting, then there will be a closed loop between this output and input terminal. And we can also apply the concept of virtual ground. So this node will be at a ground potential. And as the applied input is negative, so the current will flow from 0 to negative input voltage. And to satisfy the KCL, some finite amount of current should also come into this node. It means that the current that is flowing through the diode should flow in this direction. But if this diode D1 is conducting, the forward current should flow in this direction. It means that this diode D1 is non-conducting. So simply it will act as an open circuit. And some finite amount of current is entering to this node through this path. It means that this diode D2 is conducting and the current is flowing in this direction. So if we assume these conditions, then the equivalent circuit will look like this. So if you observe over here, now the circuit gets completed through this diode D2 and this resistor R2. And as there is a negative feedback, we can once again apply the concept of virtual ground. So this node over here will be at a ground potential. So now if we apply the KCL at this node, then we can write minus Vin divided by R1, that is equal to Vout divided by R2. And from this we can say that the output voltage Vout will be equal to minus R2 by R1 times input voltage. So this is the output voltage whenever the applied input signal is less than 0 volt. So in this modified rectifier circuit, the transfer characteristic will look like this. It means that whenever the input is greater than 0, the output will remain 0. And whenever input is less than 0, at that time, the output can be given by the expression minus R2 by R1 times Vin. So the slope of this line will be equal to minus R2 by R1. Now let us see the output waveform of this rectifier circuit. So if we apply the sine wave to this rectifier, then the output waveform will look like this. So during the positive half cycle, output is 0. And during the negative half cycle, output will be equal to minus R2 by R1 times input voltage. Similarly, you can also show that whenever the directions of this diode D1 and D2 is reversed, at that time, the transfer characteristic of this rectifier will look like this. So here, whenever the input is less than 0, at that time, the output will be equal to 0. And whenever input is greater than 0, at that time, output will be equal to minus R2 by R1 times input voltage. So try to get the transfer characteristic for this circuit. Now so far we have only discussed about the half wave rectifier circuit, but using this circuit it is also possible to design the precision full wave rectifier circuit. So let us see using this circuit how we can design the full wave rectifier circuit. Now for this circuit we understood that the output will be equal to 0 whenever the input is greater than 0, and output will be equal to minus R2 by R1 times the input voltage whenever the input is less than 0. So by setting the value of this R2 and R1, we can set the gain of the output waveform. Now here, to design this full wave rectifier circuit, the gain of this half wave rectifier is set to minus 2. So at this node, the output waveform will look like this. So whenever the input is equal to minus Vm, at that time, the output will be equal to 2 Vm. So here this yellow signal is the output waveform of this half wave rectifier, and this blue signal is the input which is applied to this half wave rectifier. Now whenever we add these two signals, then we will get the waveform of the full wave rectifier. So as you can see, using the precision half wave rectifier and the adder circuit, it is easy to design the precision full wave rectifier circuit. So I hope in this video you understood how to design the precision half wave and the full wave rectifier circuit. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.